there. I'm Jessica Kennedy from the Tailscale marketing team, and today I'm joined by Brad and Maisem, who are here to tell us a bit more about a new feature they've been working on, Tailscale SSH. Brad and Maisem, can you tell us a bit more about yourselves and what you've been working on here?
I am an engineer at Tailscale, working on code things and like the Tailscale shared client code that runs on people's machines, but also like the back end and the data plane and the control plane servers that coordinate everything. Basically everything that doesn't involve the web or Swift.
Basically the same. I'm also an engineer at Tailscale, and I also work on all the things that do not involve me designing stuff.
That's great. So what was the motivation to build Tailscale SSH?
Primarily, we got tired of like SSH key distribution. SSH key distribution is such a pain. The more employees you have, the more complex it gets. The more servers you have, the more complex it gets. Auditing, trying to figure out who has access to what, who should have access to what is a pain. And then like SSH keys go out of sync. And then you have to like build this entire system to distribute SSH keys, which we thought we don't really need to because we have WireGuard. And WireGuard already tells us who you are.
Yeah, so I built like the first prototype of this in like early 2020, like right after I joined Tailscale, because everyone's early questions was, well, I want to make SSH be only accessible over Tailscale. We've since been doing that Tailscale off thing for more things. Like we have a blog post about our Grafana off proxy. So internally, when we look at our Grafana instance, we don't have to log into Grafana. It just knows who we are from our Tailscale identity. We have like an Nginx off proxy basically that does the same thing, that it passes on the identity information to Nginx, which can pass it on to your backend application. So we're probably going to be doing more and more of this like protocol specific integration with Tailscale off for more things because it's just, you know, so convenient.
So how do you use Tailscale SSH and how is it different from what users might expect?
I mean, from like a client side, it's no different. You just use your normal SSH client. Either it'll just work because you configured it to like not have any double checks, but you can also configure in your policy something called check mode where it like verifies again that you're still present and, you know, do whatever your auth provider wants you to do again. Like, so in that case, when you connect, you'll get a little message saying like, you have to like do some extra authentication step to prove that, you know, you're still who you are or whatever. And people can configure this to be like, you know, once a day. So at the beginning of your workday, the first time you SSH, you get a little prompt and you can go to a URL to finish it. But instead of having to copy paste that, if you're already running Tailscale on your machine, we just pop your browser up to where you want to go in addition to the message. And so then once you go through the web auth flow, your SSH session just unblocks and you're SSH'd wherever you need to be. But then if you do it again, like throughout the rest of the day or whatever the configured period is, then it just works and without a prompt. And the Tailscale control plane is out of the loop at that point.
That sounds great. Well, thank you so much, Brad and Maisem. Tailscale SSH is now available for all Tailscale plans, and we can't wait for you to go try it. Thanks, guys.
Cool.
See ya.
See ya.